So we're going to talk about precision and accuracy. And like I said, precision is something you're going to use more often than accuracy, but you need to be exposed to accuracy or significant digits. So I'm going to start off by just giving you some numbers. For example, the number 2,000. Notice that it doesn't have any decimal places. So it has zero decimal places. As far as the precision, it's not very precise. It's just 2,000. That's okay. Sometimes you want to be precise, sometimes you don't need to be precise. For example, you might be getting ready to buy a TV that in the store is $19.99. You know, $1,999.99. I don't know about you, but I don't want to say $1,999.99 every time I say the price of the TV. I'm going to say 2,000. So I don't need to be very precise sometimes. So that makes sense. So it has no zero, no decimal places, so it's not that precise, okay? But this would be a little bit more precise. It has one decimal place. So maybe I'm measuring a length in this case. Who knows what this number represents, but I wanted to measure it to the tenths place. Or maybe I want it to be very precise and I want to write this down and give you two decimal places. And you might say, well, that's the same number you just wrote down, but I took the time to write this zero, which means I'm trying to be precise to the hundredths place. So I have two decimal places. And as I mentioned in a previous example, I went to the state fair a few years ago and I saw how they recorded the distances in a tractor pull. They measured it out three decimal places, so they wanted to be very precise. So maybe that could be a number that they gave in the results. So I want to be precise to the thousandths place. Yeah, that's possible. So precision, you could have no decimal places or you could have one or more. It depends on the case and what you're trying to get your point across as. Significant digits deals with accuracy. Now that's a little different. Significant digits is counting, first of all your non-zero digits, and then counting any of the digits that are exceptions to the rule. Now, for example, this number 2,000 has one non-zero digit, okay? You'll find out the rest of the problems have a little bit of an exception to the rule, but these zeros are not significant, okay? So this has one significant digit, and I'm just going to abbreviate. Exceptions to the rule are how do you deal with zeros? When they end a number like this and there's no decimal, you don't count them as significant. It's a way of saying, well, the 2 is significant because it's in the thousands position, but that's what makes this number the most significant is the 2 being in that spot, 2,000. The rest of it's just zeros, they're kind of placeholders. These zeros, however, are in between two non-zero numbers. They're in between two numbers that are automatically counted as significant. So in this case, everything listed here is going to be significant, and you have 5 significant digits. Okay, so an exception to the rule is if you put 0 in between anything that's 1 through 9. So they'll automatically be significant. Now looking at this third number, if I'm looking at this and I say, well, I know the 2s are significant. That's for sure, they're automatic. I know these zeros are because they're in between 2 significant digits. What about this last one? Actually it is. That's another exception to the rule. It's kind of a weird one. But this one will be counted as significant, and you end up with 6. Now you might say, well, is there any other way you can use 0 and it not be significant? And here's how you can. Anytime you have a number that has a decimal in it and you have some leading zeros, those are not significant. So that's the other place where you don't count it. Which means I only have 1 significant digit, okay? So think about, you don't count 0 when it ends and zeros without a decimal. You don't count those. And you don't count these when they begin it, and they have to have a decimal if they begin it. Okay, otherwise you wouldn't put them there. So those are the times when you don't count zero. The other times, they're in between it, or they end after a decimal. So how many significant digits would you have in this number? And I'm going to read it properly. 2,000 and 204 thousandths. So, yep, you'll have seven. And those zeros in between the twos and the fours, they get to be exceptions to the rule. Okay? Well, how many significant digits are in this? Very good. Four significant digits. Let's see. How many would be in this?
Four.
Now, which four? Okay, because now the 8, the 7, the 9, those are easy. Okay, those are good. You don't count zero if it ends it when there wasn't a decimal, or if it begins it when there is a decimal. So those three work. Do these get counted? No, they're just like this example. You don't count those, okay? Now, the only other question is this one. It ends it after a decimal. So it will be counted, okay? And I know this may seem weird, and I understand that it seems weird. It's just going to take some time. That's why I'm going to give you a ton of examples, okay? How about this number? Now think back to our beginning examples. 1, 2, 3, 4, they're automatic. There's at least four in there. The question is this one. If you end in zeros, you don't count it. If you begin in zeros, you don't count it. So you don't count it. All right? How about that? I'm hearing 3 and 4, so what do you think is the right answer?
3.
All right, let's think about it. I have a decimal, so I can go back to one of these examples. Did I end in a decimal? I mean, did I have a decimal and end in a zero? And I counted it. That was one of those weird, it's kind of a weird exception to a rule. So do I count it?
Yes.
Yeah, so there's actually 4. Okay. Yes, ma'am. Because there's a decimal there, you'll count the last zero. Anything that ends it, that's okay. You don't count it when it ends it, but did you see a decimal here? No. So that's why we don't count it. You begin it, has to have a decimal, no questions asked, but you begin it, you don't count those. Okay? So let's try some more. Four. The 5, 4, and 2 are automatic. But what about this one? It's in between them. So it's one of those ways you get to count it. So you have 4 significant digits. Very good. And this is just going to take maybe a little bit of training. Just kind of thinking about, all right, here are the rules for significant digits. How am I supposed to remember which one counts the zeros, which one doesn't? Okay? And like I said, you may or may not be familiar with this, so it's going to take a little bit of time. And on your worksheet and on your mastery quiz, I will ask you things like significant digits and also on the test. So just keep practicing it. Okay?